because you want to use your comb. A good barber will always keep his comb in his hand.
Makes I get two in the pictures this time.
The hair starts to grow here from the nucleus. It will always grow forward, this way, down. This is your parietal area. And this here is your occipital bone, and it grows down this way. So a good barber always know it. They'll keep their comb in their hand, okay? So what I'm doing now is I'm combing the hair forward in the direction of the natural fall in which it grows. One of the things you always want to remember when you cut your hair is that you want to use facial features as your guide. And what I mean by that is you have the eyebrow here. You always want to start here from the middle of the eyebrow to the end of the eyebrow. That is your area that you want to work in, okay? Here is the symmetry of when you look at your forehead here from the nose area. And this is here is your reference point here at the center, okay? This here is the parietal area, which is what we call a parietal ridge. What you do is you can lay your comb here right when the comb starts to leave off the surface. This is your area here that you don't want to go beyond, which is we call in barbering and cosmetology, we call these danger zones. This here is your apex, right at the top, which is the highest point of the head when you lay your comb here, okay? And so if I was to take and crisscross this, it will automatically take me right to the danger zones, okay, on each temple here. And we have a tendency in this profession to go back into the danger zones, which is the temporal area right up in here. And as you can see, we have a little bit here that he's went back probably about a half inch or so, okay? And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring the hair down to its lowest point. What I have here is I'm using a Wall Senior, and this is a number one guard. Notice I keep my comb in my hand. I'm starting from the nucleus, and I'm working my way to the front. Good, even, clear streaks. Starting from the nucleus, and I'm working my way. I always suggest that you start with your guard lever open, because remember, you can always come down. If I take too much hair off, I can't put it back on. The rule of thumb is you can always take hair lower, okay? So I'm going from the nucleus all the way to the frontal. And what this comb does is when you keep this comb in your hand and you go through the hair like this, you'll get a smoother cut. Because remember, your guard acts as a comb as well. So you're actually preparing the clipper to go through the hair. See that? Always keep this comb in your hand. And if you notice how I'm holding the clipper, with very less tension, I'm not holding it like this. My thumb is here, and I have three fingers in the back, and that's for flexibility of my wrist, okay? Standing in a stationary spot as a barber, it keeps you from moving all around the chair all day long, because remember, the chair moves.
Yeah.
Okay. I can move my client wherever I need him to. And I can stay in one central location. And it keeps me from going over here. Back over here. Right? Right now, this is what I'm calling even all over. I have a technique that I use called ABCs of haircutting. I'll explain that on another video. You notice what I did was on the right side, I switched hands. So many barbers are one-dimensional, meaning that if they're right-handed, all they'll use is their right hand. If you're on the left side, it's easier for you to use your right hand opposed to using your left hand and then have to come back like this. See how uncomfortable that can be? So you learn to be balanced in your approach to cutting hair by simply using both hands. When I'm on the left side, I cut with my right hand. I turn the chair, I switch hands to my left, and then I'm cutting on the right side. See how easy that is? This takes a little practice. I wouldn't expect you to do that all on the first try. I'm bringing the hair down to its lowest point, cutting the combing the hair in the direction that I want to cut. Take my index finger, pull the ear down, which allows me to get closer to the base of the perimeter. Okay, turn my client. Switch hands. I'm in this direction. Keeping that comb in my hand. Okay, now what we're going to do is, I'm one of those firm believers in my approach and in my technique that barbers, cosmetologists, stylists are like artists. And this is your canvas that you're actually working on. And I like to line the hair before the haircut, and I like to line the hair midway, and the last thing is to line it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to line. I always like to start on the left side behind the ear. And I always like to say one of the techniques that you really want to pay attention to when you're cutting hair is you always want to pull the hair to the line that you want to create. Okay? And the reason for that is simply that when you make your line here, once you pull the hair to the line, no matter what you do, you can take that and move it up this way, it'll never go beyond that line. That's one of the reasons why you always want to pull the hair to the line that you want to create, okay? Because we say in barbering that hair cutting is probably 95% an illusion. And the reason why I say that is because when you look at the symmetry of facial features, one side is always different than the other side. One side of the hair grows different than the other side. One eye sits up higher than the other side. One eyebrow is different than the other eyebrow. So it's up to the barber stylist per se to create the illusion to get it as close to perfection as possible, if that makes any sense. And remember, come here again, combing the hair to the line that I want to create. Of course, my client here is just relaxing, so what I use is my other hand to create stability. And it keeps me grounded. And if you notice here, I'm pulling the hair to the line that I want to create, and I'm using the corner of my blade. Pull the hair, and as you can see. It's like an artist that's drawing on a piece of canvas. He takes it in his sculpts and he creates. And there you have it. And the old Egyptian term called Barber. Always cut directly in front of your object. You'll see some people, they'll be cutting off to the side like this. They'll be lining the hair up like this. Always stand, turn the client directly towards you. So this is directly in front. Okay? When you're lining up the front, you always want to use your reference point. Remember what we were talking about earlier, the center of the forehead. Because some people's eyes are further apart, some people's eyes are closer together. Everybody's facial features are different and they vary. So what you want to do is, you want to use your center as a reference point. And this is where I will make my initial cut. Okay? And I base my whole frontal hairline off of this initial cut right here. Okay? And then I come over and make my 90 degree here. I pull the hair to the line that I want to create. If you notice here, angles are very important. Because obviously someone put in here to keep from this angle here of making it appear to go back further. So this is what I would do, pull the hair to the line, and I would give him just a slight angle, not much. My client is falling asleep on me. That's always a good sign too, that he trusts you. The client falls asleep on you, they trust you. Okay? And now all I have to do is go from A to B. And see, one of the things is, if I was to start here and try to go over, see all the distance I would have to travel, and all the distance I would have to travel, I'm more likely to have an uneven hairline, or to create one. So the shortest distance from A to B is from my reference point to the corner. And that's the purpose for doing that. So all I have to do now is connect from my center reference point to here. And see, what I'm doing is I'm keeping my clippers parallel to the floor. Everything is parallel. Sometimes, you know, it's easy to get into your different, keep it parallel to the floor. Every once in a while, just check your positioning and make sure that you're parallel, okay? And then to check what I'm doing here, all I had to do is turn my corners this way, my clippers per se, and it should fit right in the corner where I cut. There you have it. See it? Fits in there like a glove. And that's my way of checking my work. And then when you look at him from the front, just on that one side, you can see that we're headed for excellent hair. One of the things that I like to teach, which the students I found really enjoy, is to understand the why behind everything that you do. It's one thing for someone to tell you how to do something or show you how to do something, but never explain the why behind what you do. And I'm one of those type of instructors, I like to explain the why. And one of the reasons why I like to explain the why is because the people who know how to do things will always work for the people who know why. When you know the why, you're able to teach it.